Hello and welcome. So let's begin with topic number 3, which is refraction of light, and that is the name of the chapter also. So what we mean by refraction of light, or what do we understand by refraction? Well, we all know that when we take a glass of water and if it is half filled, and when we immerse the pencil in it, the pencil appears to be bent. Now why is it so? One more question. When we all go to picnic or a swimming pool, the depth of the swimming pool is much shallower than exact or actual depth. What could be the reason behind this? Well, the answer to both of this question is refraction of light. What we mean by refraction of light? See, when we send a light from one medium to another medium, some part of the light bends. Now, what we mean by that? Let's understand. The light rays, or the light, changes its direction while going from one transparent medium to another transparent medium. This is called refraction of light. Let's understand few terms in more good way. First is this transparent medium. What we mean by transparent medium? Transparent medium means through which light rays can pass. The medium through which light rays can pass is called as transparent medium. Similarly, so what do we understand by this? When we send ray of light from one medium to another medium, the light will bend. And this bending of light is called as refraction of light. Okay? So, the bending of light means refraction of light. So, let's understand why this light bends and how exactly this light bends. So, for doing that, we have to understand the glass slab experiment. For that, we are going to take a rectangular glass slab. Now, before we begin with the experiment, now I want you to understand two terms in a more good way. One is called as rarer medium and second is called as denser medium. Now, what we mean by rarer medium and what is denser medium? See, this glass slab or glass in comparison to air have more particles. Since the particles are dense, the glass slab will act as a denser medium. The glass slab is acting as a denser medium. But in comparison to glass slab, there will be less particles in air. Since there will be less particles in air, the air will act as a rarer medium. So these are the two different concepts, rarer medium, denser medium. In rarer medium, the particles will be less. In denser medium, the particles will be more. Okay, so now let's start. How do we start this experiment? So the concept of refraction was, when we pass light through any medium, from one medium to another medium, the light will bend. The light will bend because of refraction. Now how exactly this light bends and how is this experiment going on? Let's see. So this is the actual diagram after performing experiment. When we are passing ray of light, okay, when we are sending some ray of light, these rays will be called as, of course, incident ray. This ray of light, after going from this one medium to another medium, that is, this is glass or glass slab, it will bend. Just like how the pencil got bended in case of the half-filled glass of water. So now, this light rays will bend and it will bend towards or it may bend away from the normal. Okay, so the rays which we are sending are called as incident ray, and the rays which we get after bending inside second medium are called refracted ray. Okay, so this is where first bending occurred. The light has bended when it passed from rarer to denser medium. Why rarer to denser? Because since this is a glass slab, the glass slab was acting as a denser medium, and outside is the air. Since the outer part is the air, air is a rarer medium. So light is traveling from rarer to denser medium. So when the light is traveling from one medium to another medium, it has bended. Now the light doesn't stop here. It wants to go on the another path. So now light will try to follow and it will go straight. Once it reaches over here, it wants to follow and it wants to get out of this glass slab. Since the light comes out of the glass slab, it is coming from denser to rarer medium. Means once again, it is changing its medium. Since it is changing its medium, it will again bend. And this bending is because of refraction. Now, if you observe very carefully, the ray of light was supposed to travel in this path initially, if the glass slab was not there. But because of glass slab has bent the ray of light and it has changed the path of light. And while getting the light on the outer path, we got this ray. And this ray is called as emergent ray. Means the light is emerging out of the glass slab. Okay, so let's quickly revise. The light rays which we are sending are called incident ray. The ray of light is coming. The light gets bent inside this glass slab. This ray of light is called as refracted ray. There are two angles over here. The angle made by incident ray with normal is called angle of incidence. The angle made by refracted ray with normal is called angle of refraction. And third is, when the light comes out of this glass slab, this ray is called emergent ray, and the angle made by emergent ray with normal is called angle of emergence. Okay, so this was about how the glass slab experiment got the result to us. Now, the ray of light which was supposed to come straight, this is the direction of the ray of light or incident ray, which is drawn by the dotted line. And this is the direction of the emergent ray. You can see there is a shift in this direction. Okay, this is the glass slab experiment. Okay, so we need to understand few terms in this glass slab experiment. This PQRS is a rectangular glass slab which is acting as a denser medium. Okay, which is made up of course glass. Outside is a rarer medium. AO is an incident ray. OB is a refracted ray. And BC is acting as an emergent ray. I is angle of incidence. R is angle of refraction. And E is the angle of emergence or emergent. Okay, so this is the glass slab experiment, how it got the result to us, which help us to understand how light bends when it travels from one medium to another. Now, this is the actual experimental setup, how do we can perform this experiment. So, for that, we need to take a piece of paper and a rectangular glass slab. We have to place rectangular glass slab and we are supposed to draw the outline in such a way that we get a rectangle. Now, when we pass the ray of light, in case of experiment, we'll show that with the help of a line, a straight line. We'll draw a line over here and we'll place two pins in such a way that we have to observe these two pins from the another end, from this end. If you observe these pins from this particular end in such a way that all these three and four pins has to be in a same line. So let me show in next pic. It is observing like this. We have a glass slab over here. This is an incident ray on which we have placed a pin. Now if you observe from the another end, all these four pins has to be in a straight line. And once we remove this glass slab, we get a straight glass slab diagram, what we have seen as a part of reflection. Okay, so this is about refraction of light, means how does exactly the light bends. And this is the actual wave, when the light is passed from a glass slab, the light gets bent. So what we mean by refraction, the meaning of refraction is bending of light. Meaning of refraction means bending of light. Bending of light, refraction of light, one and the same concept. Now children, refraction of light occurred. Now we must also ask the question, as I said, we never mug up physics and we should not understand physics by just learning and by adding the thing. The next question should be, why does the light bends? Yes. Why does the light bends? When the refraction is occurring, why the light is bending? Or who is actually bending the ray of light? The answer to this question is also same, coming from the same concept, what we have done in case of rectilinear propagation and in the reflection of light. That is, it's very simple. When light travels from one transparent medium to another transparent medium, its velocity is actually changing. Means the velocity of the light may increase or the velocity may decrease. Now how it is actually occurring? Let's see. See, this was the glass slab. Glass slab was acting as a denser medium, and above and below and on the either side of the glass slab there is an air. The air is acting as a rarer medium. So when ray of light is coming from rarer to denser medium, in rarer medium we know there are less particles and in denser medium there are more particles. So when light is coming from rarer to denser medium, they have to face more particles or they have to encounter more particles. Means they will stop the ray of light to come, and because of this stop, the velocity of light will reduce. Since the velocity of the light is reducing, the light is getting to bend, means light is bending. And that was the answer, that was the meaning and the concept behind the answer. When the light is coming from one medium to another medium in or during refraction, its velocity changes. So now we understand, when the light is coming from rarer to denser medium, the light is encountering more particles, and because of this its velocity decreases, and because of that velocity, because of this decrease in the velocity, the light is bending. Now come over here. When the light is coming, now of course light wants to travel or it wants to exit. So light will travel from denser to rarer medium. Since the light is traveling from denser to rarer medium, now in rarer medium there are more particles. Since there are in rarer medium there are less particles. Since there are less particles, they will force less or they will offer less resistance to the light. Therefore, light can pass easily and thus light will bend more and its velocity increases. And in this way, we make the concept why exactly the velocity of light and bending of light is related. Refraction means bending of light. And why does the light bends? Because its velocity changes. The velocity may increase or the velocity may decrease. This is the concept and phenomena and the principle behind the refraction of light. So after this, there are three different cases to understand how light will bend or how light will change. The first case is when light travels from rarer medium to denser medium. We have just discussed this. Let's discuss in more detail. When a light is traveling from rarer medium to denser medium, we have taken over here air and glass. Okay, glass, of course, there are more particles. It will act as a denser medium and outside is the air. Air has less particles. Less particle, rarer medium. More particle, denser medium. So, first case says that when light is traveling from rarer to denser medium, what will happen? Kya hoga? So, the first thing is light will bend towards the normal. This straight line is a normal. This is incident ray and this is refracted ray. When light is traveling from rarer to denser medium, it will bend towards the normal. It will bend towards the normal. Why? Remember the concept. Why does the light bend? The light bends because its velocity changes. The light bends because its velocity changes. Why the velocity changes? When the light is going from one medium to another medium, there may be more or less particles. In this case, when light is coming from rarer to denser medium, there are more particles. Since there are more particles, light will get more opposition and thus light is, the velocity of the light changes or it decreases. Since the velocity of light decreases, it will bend towards the normal. The answer is when light travels from rarer medium to denser medium, its velocity decreases and thus light bends towards the normal. The same can be answered in this way also. In the above case, I means angle of incidence will be greater than R angle of refraction. Angle of incidence will be greater than angle of refraction. Why? See, this is angle of incidence. And since light is bending towards the normal, the angle got reduced. Since the angle got reduced, we have got smaller angle. And thus, the angle of incidence is greater than angle of refraction. The same concept and the question can be asked in this way. What will happen or what is happening when angle of incidence is greater than angle of refraction? The answer should be, in this case, light is traveling from rarer to denser medium. Because when light travels from rarer to denser medium, its velocity decreases. Since its velocity decreases, it bends towards the normal. Since it bends towards the normal, the angle of refraction decreases. That was the first case. Let's see second case. What could be the second case? The exact opposite of the first. What was first? Light was traveling from rarer to denser. Second is, light is traveling from denser to rarer. You might be observing, how does the light can travel from denser to rarer? Let's take an example of fish tank. Okay, we make use of fish tank, inside that we make use of torches for decorative purpose. So when light is coming outside, means it is coming from glass or water towards the air. When the light is coming from glass towards the air, means it is coming from denser to rarer. Since the light is coming from denser to rarer, now tell me, light is coming from denser to rarer, what will occur? Since it is coming from denser to rarer, in rarer medium there will be less particles. Since there will be less particles, there will be less opposition or less resistance to the flow of light. And because of that, its velocity increases. And because its velocity increases, it will travel away from the normal. So that's the answer. When the light travels from denser medium to rarer medium, its velocity increases. And thus, light bends away from the normal. Okay, and on the other hand, we can write it as a part of note, I is less than R. I means angle of incidence is smaller than angle of refraction. Now you must tell me the exact opposite case. The above concept can be asked in different way. How? What will happen when the I or angle of incidence is less than angle of refraction? When angle of incidence is less than angle of refraction, means light is traveling from denser to rarer medium. Since it is traveling from denser to rarer medium, its velocity increases. Since its velocity increases, it is bending away from the normal. So the two phenomena, two concepts, when light travels from rarer to denser, it bends towards the normal. and when it travels from denser to rarer, it bends away from the normal. I repeat, when light travels from rarer to denser, it bends towards the normal, and when light travels from denser to rarer, it bends away from the normal. You might be wondering, are there any more cases? Yes, there's one more last, and that is this. If light travels along the normal, matlab, if I put or if I pass light straight as a perpendicular pass kiya to kya hoga? Well, let's see. If I take a ray of light and pass straight, okay, at an angle of normal, matlab seedha pass karo, as a straight pass karo, what will happen? See, when a light is passing straight normal, it is the angle of incidence is actually becoming zero. And since it is becoming zero, all the particles are encountering the same particle. So in this case, the velocity does not change. And since the velocity is not changing, in this particular case, light will not bend. Okay, it will go straight. So that's the answer. When light is incident normally, that is straight, at a boundary between the two medium, it does not change its direction, means it does not change its velocity actually, and hence it does not undergo refraction. Okay, so that was the third case which make us understand how exactly the light was performing and how actually the light was behaving. So at the end of this section, we conclude finally following three things. One is rectilinear propagation. The first case, the first was rectilinear propagation means light travels in a straight line path. Second property of light was reflection of light. What we mean by reflection of light? The turning back of light. Okay, reflection means turning back of light. Till this point, it was about till 9th standard. And third was refraction. This is something new for us. Refraction means bending of light. Refraction means bending of light. Why does the light bends? Because when light travels from one medium to another medium, its velocity changes. Why does the velocity changes? Of course, that must be the answer you must figure out and let me know. Well, can you answer it or not? So that was the end of the section. Thank you.